Is this power real? Is it really happening? And you saw with your eyes so many people experiencing the power of God. When you believe totally and completely on word, knowledge, truth, you experience the power. The secret is that you first believe, even without any physical evidence, what God said in His Word. And when you believe in the spiritual evidence, you experience the physical manifestation of God's power. Even if you are standing there and saying, God, you did not touch me. It is not necessary that only when you fall on the ground that the Lord has touched you. It is by your believing that the Lord has touched you, even without any physical evidence. But because you are believing the promise of God, you experience the power of God. There are many a times, many people who do not fall on the ground. But that does not mean that they have not received the Holy Ghost. When they continue to believe that they have received the Holy Spirit, that continuous believing, consistent believing in the Word of God is what is going to give them the power of God manifested in their life. When we believe your word, we confess your word, we see you manifesting your power. Lord, you are an invisible God. Your power, your spirit is invisible. But yet, O Lord, your invisible spirit shows visible signs and wonders in our midst. Thank you for showing us this secret. Thank you for showing us, O Lord, how important it is to believe in your word. How important it is to continue to allow your word to govern our life. Thank you for this beautiful day that we had in your presence. And thank you, Lord, for giving us this beautiful experience. We have received your touch, and Holy Spirit, you have come in each one's heart, because your word says 120 were gathered on the day of Pentecost each one of them had the touch of the Holy Spirit, and tongues of fire came upon them. Loving Father, thank you for this assurance. Thank you for this confidence that we have in your word. As we go out of this place, O Lord, we go out with joy in our heart, with confidence in our heart, that truly you are a living God whose word is living and whose word is manifested in our midst. Just as this mother experienced, and she said, I could pray, I could praise God like never before in my life. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that all of us who have been listening to your word from the past 2 days thirst and seek you more and more of your word and of your spirit. And the more they seek your fellowship, O Lord, I thank you that you will reveal yourself to them. Thank you and praise you for all these wonderful moments that we had in your presence. And loving Father, we bow down to your Lordship and we give you glory. And we thank you, Lord, for all these signs and wonders that you have performed in our midst. All glory, all praise, and all honor to you, O loving Master, O loving Father, our mighty God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We got some time, another 10 minutes. I want you to just share with me what was your experience. What happened to you?
Power is forcing me.
For the first time you experienced this?
First time I fell down, then shivering my hands.
Okay. Hey, hold on. Come here. Okay, you can go. What happened to you?
Something pushed me down, that only I felt.
And what happened when you were down?
Continuously I'm praising God without a non-stop.
Non-stop
I'm praising God.
Wow, was that experience beautiful?
Yes, so really so beautiful.
So beautiful, okay. Next, what happened to you?
Before I did not believe, that is I did not got. Just now here I came, that time Jesus came to near me, then he hold me, that time I cannot able to stand, then I fall.
Wow, praise God. First you were in unbelief and that time nothing happened. But when you change your mind and your thinking, suddenly you experience the power of God. Good, God bless you. Next one, what happened to you? Listen, please understand. Listen, you might be saying, hey brother, everybody fell, I did not fall. Is that your thinking? Come on. I want to tell you, there are people whom I have seen who have never fallen down. They never had an experience of falling down, okay? But you have never fallen. Now, like for example, this doctor is lifting his hand up. Uncle Brito is lifting his hand up. But they had a different experience. Their life from that day on has never been the same. He has never fallen in his life. He has not fallen. But that doesn't mean he has not received the Holy Spirit. So please understand, I've seen people who have fallen 1,000 times, but have not yet changed their thinking. Their life is still the same. And there are people who have not fallen, but they have believed for the Holy Spirit to come upon their life and change their thinking. And there, the power of God began to flow. Okay? So please do not gauge yourself that if I fall, oh, the Holy Ghost came. If I don't fall, the Holy Ghost did not come. Did you experience any other thing when you were standing here and speaking God's word?
I thought I'm going to fall down, but I didn't get.
Okay. But was there, oh, forget the falling, any other experience that you had?
To praise Him more and more.
Which you could not do before?
I praised.
But now was it different?
Now also I praised.
But was it different? Is there any difference before and now?
Yes, it is different.
Much difference? Yeah, that's what I want to ask you. God bless you. What happened to you? Yeah, you can.
Okay, I'm pushing. Okay.
that time one power came.
Okay.
I don't know next.
You don't know what happened to you after that. Okay, God bless you. Why were you crying?
I believe that when Holy Ghost came into me, so that I cried a lot. And when brothers touched in my head and prayed that in, I lost my balance.
Oh, you lost your balance, that's why you fell down. You did not fall down, but you experienced a beautiful experience, isn't it? Yeah, here is a precious child who did not fall down, but yet she experienced the power of God. Hallelujah. What happened to you?
Somebody is touching me, so that one power is came, but I did not fall down.
Was it different? You enjoyed that? Oh, praise God. God bless you. And what happened to you three? None of your friends came. Why did they not come? Huh? Oh, you all have got a white sari, and if I fall, it will become dirty. Good. I understand. Okay, what happened to you? Come here, no.
First, I did not believe. Then, when I stand here, I going to fall down. But
I was controlling myself.
Yes.
Yes, because my sari is going to become dirty, and the ones who have got a brownish sari, even if they fall, no problem. It can't be seen. God bless you. You are more worried about your sari than getting your heart cleaned. Thank God for the honest answer. And what about you? The same answer?
First, really I did not believe. After when I was here, I'm going to fall down, but I'm trying my best. And really I opened my heart and prayed this time.
And did you experience the power? Forget about the falling. Did you experience some change in you?
Something
happened.
I opened my heart and prayed to Jesus.
And you had a good time with Jesus?
Yeah.
Yeah. And what happened to you?
When God is touching me, that time the blood is coming, like that I am feeling in my head.
Was it a beautiful experience? Yes. Good. And what about the others? I'm going to call them one by one. Please come here. All the clean white saris. Please come here. Hello, come here. Good, thank you. Your saris are going to get dirty, isn't it? Why you did not come? So was simply at all, we had a retreat for them. They experience every day of God. So simply at all, we had a retreat for you. And not like that, then some other like that. Okay, what was your experience when you were sitting there? Your eyes were open and you're watching everywhere. Oh yeah, I saw that. You know, I am very, very sharp in looking at who is doing what. What was your experience?
Something, Holy Spirit is coming. I experienced better. I don't know what to say.
God bless you all. And thank you very much. Praise the Lord. Can we give the Lord a big hand of praise?
Can you please close your eyes? Heavenly Father, thank you for sending your Son to redeem us. Thank you for sending your Holy Spirit to touch us, heal us, cleanse us, making us newborns again, this time born in spirit, to be led by spirit. As we prayed, Lord, when these people get out of this building, as Jesus prayed the last prayer in the Gethsemane, let none of them who came here be given away to the powers of hell, Lord. Let your powers of heaven reign over this place and lead them to the promised land. Lead them to the land of abundance in this world and elsewhere. For the people who are wondering, how can heaven be here? It's already amongst us. The presence of God is amongst us. Let's all praise and thank Him for 1 minute in our heart. Whoever wants to praise Him, Lord, please, please, feel free. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lead us, 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 Lord. Now, whoever is taking a firm decision like Isaiah took, I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will take your people in my heart. Please, please put up your hands. Please put up your hands. Only those people who very, very honestly feel in the heart that God will touch and lead you and to take His news, take His words to the ends of the world, please put up your hands. And God wants to see how many people are willing to go far and wide and spread His name. Please. Let His name be glorified. Can you please give a big hand for these people? Only this much? Only this much? Please. We are going to spread the word of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let your name be glorified. We ask in the name of Christ Jesus, Lord and Savior. Amen. One song, any
so, dear brothers and sisters, thank God, first of all, for the wonderful things He has done today, the marvelous wonders He has really infused in the hearts of people gathered here. And this is a blessed hall because of the prayer that is taking place here and the presence of all the members of the team. So I thank them specially. And also, many of you are really being touched, I know that, from morning till now. So, I mean, much taken up by the prayer, a session, the teaching, and so on. Surely we'll carry on the teachings Brother has given us, Brother John says, give us, imbued us. Surely it will be very profitable for us, for our religious life also, to share with people.